My name is Jaron Johnson, and I am here for my Indian economy and policy presentation on COVID-19 impacts on the Indian agriculture. During these challenging times, how has an Indian agriculture responded to the crisis, and how the government measures affect the 140 million farm households across the country, and thereafter in the impact of the economy of India? I would like to address the immediate challenges that COVID-19 has posed to the farm sector and suggest mitigation measures to ensure a sustainable agriculture system in the post-crisis period. Immediately after the nationwide lockdown was announced, the Indian Finance Minister declared an INR 1.7 trillion package, which contained an advance release of INR 2000 to bank accounts of the farmers as income support under PM Kisan scheme. The government also raised the wage rate for the workers engaged under the NREGS and introduced Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Yojana. Additional grain allotments to registered beneficiaries were also announced for the next 3 months. Cash and food assistance to the persons engaged in the informal sector, mostly migrant laborers, have also been announced, for which a separate PM CARES fund has been created. The Reserve Bank of India granted a moratorium of 3 months on agricultural terms and crop loans by banking institutions, with 3% concession on the interest rate of crop loans up to INR 3 lakhs for borrowers with good repayment behavior. In spite of all the measures introduced by the government, it is expected that the COVID pandemic will continue to have negative implications in the agricultural sector, making the food, grains, fruits and vegetables and other essential items available to the consumers, both in rural and urban areas, is the most critical challenge for the government during the lockdown period. Smooth functioning of the supply chain with adequate safety measures for the people involved is of paramount importance. Transportation of public distribution system items to last mile delivery agents by both rail and road has to be ensured by the respective government agencies. Distribution of the commodities to vulnerable populations while maintaining prescribed guidelines and protocol, particularly over social distancing, must be effectively monitored. The sale of dairy products, fish, poultry, etc. has also been hit during the lockdown period, as the uptake by the organized industry players has been affected due to the shortage of workforce and transport issues. As the weather has been very erratic over the past few months in many parts, harvested products must also be protected from such risks. While the focus of the government is to protect the lives of every citizen, people in on agriculture and allied activities, mostly those losing their income from the informal employment at this lockdown period, have to be provided with alternative avenues like cash transfers till the economy bounces back. To sustain the demand for the agricultural commodities, investments in the key logistics must be enhanced. Moreover, e-commerce and delivery companies and startup needs to be encouraged with suitable policies and incentives. To answer queries related to the announced measures of the government and addressing grievances of farmers, dedicated toll-free helpline call centers must be established by the government. State governments must gear up their machineries for smooth procurement operations of farmers' marketable surpluses at MSP or through other price support schemes. As the COVID-19 pandemic is a health crisis of unprecedented proportions, the major share of the future budget allocations would be a portion for the health sector. However, investment should not be crowded out of the primary sector, and the government must focus attention on the agriculture sector as a growth engine and also to bring resilience in food security. Structural reforms such as land leasing, contract farming, and private agricultural markets, etc., have long been advocated to bring enhanced investment into the agriculture sector and to push its growth. However, there has not been uniform implementation of these legislations by the state governments, and so the full potential of the sector is unrealized. These reforms need significant push from the concerned bodies to reap its benefits. There have been global concerns, rather speculations, on restriction of the exports of agriculture commodities by few global players. India being trade surplus on commodities like rice, meat, milk products, tea, honey, horticulture products, etc., may seize opportunities by exporting such products with a stable agri exports policy. Development of export supportive infrastructure and logistics would need investments and support of the private sector that will be in the long-term interest of farmers in boosting their income. Thank you.